Welcome to this training course on BricsCAD BIM. Today we're going to talk a bit about increasing the geometric LOD of your model. So we'll talk about increasing the detail on existing components, increasing detail between walls and slabs, for instance, and how to copy these details over in a smart way in the rest of your model. So let's open BricsCAD BIM to see what this looks like in the software. Let me activate this section plane here so we can look inside. I can see here I have a couple of doors already inserted in the building. These doors actually came from our library. So the component library shipped with BricsCAD BIM. But you can see that there's currently no doorknob in this door. So maybe I want to create a slightly higher level of detail door so I know where the doorknob is. So let me first of all open a copy of this existing door, and we'll just work straight from there. Let me isolate the main panel of the door so we can focus on that. And we'll first of all create a sort of relief in the door by offsetting the outer edge to create a polyline, and then by extruding this polyline inward over a distance of 10 mil, like this. I'll do the same on the other side. And now let's add a doorknob. I will first of all create a new layer called Door Handle. And set this as my currently active layer. And I'll create a box of, let's say, 60 by 60 with a height of 10 mil. I'll create a new object, 18 by 18 by 30. Using the shift key, I will lock this plane to create a new box of, again, the same dimensions. So this is just some basic modeling that I'm doing. If you don't know or can't follow how I created this, please take a look again at the modeling chapter of this course so you understand what I'm doing. Okay, let me union these two entities here, and I'm actually going to move it using the manipulator. So that it's centered in this main box. Okay. Now, actually, I'm going to turn this into a cylindrical object if I want to. So, using the fillet command will be the easiest way to do so. So, I will create a selection box, actually, like this. And before choosing my selection box, I will hit Control twice to select all edges. Actually, first of all, I'm going to start with all of these edges here to create a fillet. Like this, of 9 millimeters. And I'll do the same for these edges to make this also a round entity. Like so. Okay. So that's our door handle. Let's move it a bit Let's say in that direction. And let's also mirror it and copy it over to the other side, like this. So now I can either save this drawing just as a new DWG, or I can add it to my library, whichever is the easiest. So let me just save this drawing here. I'll just save it next to my actual project. And when I go back to my building now, I can choose to replace the door that I already had inserted by the one we just created, so I can use the BM replace command. From file. And choose the file we just created. There we go. I can actually do the same for all the other doors, so I'll just select all of them. Like this. Okay, so that was how to increase the level of detail on an existing component, like a door. Now, what if we want to increase the level of detail of, let's say, walls and slabs coming together? So let me open this next drawing here, 3B. As I can see, I have composition plies, so multi-ply materials already assigned to my slabs and walls. Actually, let me enable my render materials so I can see it a bit more clearly even. So I have different materials inside these wall and slab entities. Now, currently, this this slab is floating in midair. I mean, this wouldn't happen in real life because the slab would just fall down if it was constructed like this. So typically, the structural layer of the slab will be resting on top of the structural layer of the wall. In BricsCAD BIM, you actually have the full freedom to create this detail or this connection however you want it, by using something called the composition level of detail, which basically gives you the possibility to work with individual plies. So if I enable this setting here, I can now see, if I hit the tab key, so using the tab key, I can cycle through different entities or sub-entities which are behind my cursor. And I can see, if I hit tab key a few times, that I can select the ply face, or highlight the ply face of this one ply, which is the concrete layer of the slab. I have to use tab because I'm actually behind this wall. If I would hide this wall, I can see I can select separate ply faces. Like this. You have to make sure your phase detection is enabled. Okay, so let me show this wall again, and again use the tab key to cycle through different plies, and I can now choose to push-pull this one single ply to, let's say, to this location. By default, my subtract is enabled, so if I choose this, it will automatically subtract this volume also from this wall. I can do the same to these two plies here. So just select them both, again using the tab key, and I can push-pull just like this. So now we've done this for the entire width of this wall. So if I isolate the slab here, it's done over the entire width or the entire length of this wall. But it's obviously not yet done in the rest of the building. So if I would take a look at, let's say, one floor lower, we still have the old situation. And obviously we don't want to do this manually for every single location of the drawing, because that would take too much time people would skip over it and people would just not do it. Now, if I want to have this detail everywhere, for example, because I want to have a correct estimate of the volume of concrete or the area of tiling, then I have to do this in the model itself. Now, to avoid doing this manually, we will again use a Propagate tool. So Propagate, basically it's a function to copy in a smart way situations and geometry over to other places in the model based on its context. So Propagate always needs a one or more reference solids. So if I choose Propagate, it asks for reference solids. So these are the situations or the solids that create the context around which the detail is constructed. So in this case, I'm talking about a slab and the wall coming together. So these two entities are the actual reference solids. So as it says in the description, these will not be copied but used to match other locations. So I can select the slab and the wall and press enter. And then optionally it asks you to select detail objects. So detail objects are objects that will be copied over to these new locations. For example, in this case, I could have a skirting board here that I want to copy over to the other locations. That would be a detail object. Or I could have like an insulation block that I want to copy over. In this case, I don't actually have any detail objects because I didn't create anything new. I just altered the existing wall and slab, which are my reference solids. So I will just press enter to accept. And it creates a 2D abstraction of this detail, which it will then try to match over to the other locations in my drawing. So I'll press enter to accept. Now it searches where can I apply this detail in the rest of the drawing based on the context that it found. So in this case, it found it's a wall and a slab coming together. Each of these walls and slabs have a set number of plies. And based on that information, it found these locations. So each green strip here is a location where it can apply the detail. And it's attached to this little widget, which we can use to either turn off or in some cases choose different configurations. So for example, in this case, I want to apply this detail everywhere except on the ground floor because maybe I want to create a foundation element, so my detail will be a bit different. So I will just select all of the ground floor widgets and turn them off to disable them. And then just press enter to accept all of the remaining situations. So now I can see, if I take a look closer at my detail, that this detail is now actually applied on each floor and actually around the entire building on every side. So if I would now isolate this slab here, you will see it's actually done in full 3D as well. Well, not on this side because it's a different wall situation there. But that means that you always have a correct volume of concrete, the correct area of tiling, and so on when you do your takeoffs. Now, in this case, we created a detail manually in one location and then copied it over to the rest of the drawing. Now, what if we want to save this detail in the library so we can reuse it over the same project or in different projects? That's actually also possible using the details panel. So details panel, you can find here with this little Propagate icon. In my case, I already have a couple of different folders set up for different projects. By default, this will be empty or pretty much empty. This training course comes with a preset folder of details that you can just copy paste into your program data folder. So under program data, Bricsys details. There you can have different folders. So the folder that was delivered with the training course can be copied in here. It will show up in your panel. Or what you can also do is inside BricsCAD, in the details panel, go to manage libraries, go to directory path, and you can add paths to this list. So you can add a new path, hit these little ellipses here, and then select the folder that was shipped with this training course. So you will have access to all the details there. So then they should appear in your panel here, and you can start using them in your models. Okay, so let's change to this other drawing here, 3C. I will take a look at some of the details that were delivered with this training. And I'll go to this wall-wall connections folder, which contains a couple of details that we now can reuse in our model. We can see here in this case, we have 6 details in this folder. If you have a lot of details and you want to find them more easily, you can also work with tags. So each detail actually has some tags, some of which are user-generated, others are automatically generated based on the context. And I can type, for example, wall and add this wall tag. So now it will search on details with this wall tag. Let's open this one detail here, this W55 cavity brick gypsum. And I can see here a little preview of the detail itself. So what the detail looks like. In this case, it's 2 walls coming together with this little this butted connection for the inner layers and this mitered connection for the outer layer. I can see all the tags associated with this detail, all of which were automatically generated. So this detail I can now just easily propagate by hitting the propagate key, and it will search for possible locations where I can apply this detail. So it finds that all of these edge locations, or all of these 2 walls coming together in an L shape, can have this detail. I can again choose not to enable some of the details like this, and press enter. And now I can see that my plies are correctly connected like it was indicated in the detail or in the preview, as opposed to where I didn't enable it. So here we have a different situation that still needs to be fixed or solved afterwards. We can again do the same on this second building. So instead of opening detail and clicking propagate, I can also just drag and drop it into my drawing, and it will start the propagate command. Or I can again do the same steps. In this case, I'll just accept everything. And now I can see that everything is properly connected like it should be. Okay, that's everything for this module on increasing geometric LOD of your model. So we saw how to increase the LOD, or the detail, level of detail in an existing component like a door in your model. We also saw how to create a proper connection between wall and slabs, or between different walls, how to propagate this connection over to other locations in your drawing or different drawings, and how to use pre-made or existing details over your different projects. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next session about MEP modeling.